All right, I said in the last video that we were done, but I decided to try one other thing, which was to load this page into Internet Explorer. And as you can see, it's not actually resizing things properly. So I'm going to show you how to debug that. I'm going to go to Developer Tools, which is much more awkward in Internet Explorer than Chrome, but and then I'm going to click Start Debugging and Reload. And then if I go ahead and put a breakpoint on the part that's resizing the tiles and hit reload again, it stops here. And so let me go ahead and look at what I have. So tile width is not a number. Extra is okay. Tile height is not a number. Font size is not a number, and so on. So let's go up here and see what's going on. So tile width is not a number. Window width is not a number. So let's look at window width. Window.width. That works fine. Margin, though, is not a number. So let's look at body CSS margin. And we see that it's returning an empty string. So that's our problem. When you do parseInt of that, you get not a number. So what I'm going to do, I actually know that the margin is 0 because that's what I set it to, but for now I'm just going to go ahead and OR 0. So that way, if it's not set, it's going to return 0 as a default. And let's go ahead and actually continue. Oh, that's the browser window. So let's go ahead and get rid of that and reload. And now it works. So it turned out that we only had to change one line in order to get it to work on Internet Explorer. Let's go ahead and try Firefox. This was IE10, by the way. And I have an old version of Firefox, so let's see what happens there. There it is. Okay, so let's go ahead and copy the URL and paste it in. And it works fine. So not bad for cross-browser compatibility. If I was really doing this as a professional product, I'd also try Opera and Safari and various versions of IE and Chrome and so on, but that's enough for now.